In this clip, I will demonstrate the process of preparing a payment by bank transfer. Bank transfer payments can be prepared manually as well as automatically from the Financials menu, Accounts Payable, Payments, Bank Transfers menu. Let's open a payment manually in the Payments by Bank Transfer form. First, we'll select a vendor whom we wish to pay. If we are paying a ledger account rather than a vendor, we record the account number manually rather than select it from a choose list. If necessary, you can change a vendor's name, assuming that the change name option is flagged for this vendor in the vendor's form. The current date appears automatically in the date column, where it may be revised, and a temporary number appears in the payment number column. In the paying bank account column, we choose the account from which to make the payment to the vendor. In the payment date column, we record the date on which to make the transfer will actually take place. The vendor's bank tab displays the details of the vendor's bank account as defined in the bank account details sublevel of the financial parameters for vendors form. These details can be updated as needed. Now we enter the flag invoices for payment sublevel form and flag the pay column for every invoice to be paid off by this bank transfer. Any invoice that is flagged in the checking column cannot be included in the payment. If a particular invoice has already been partially paid, the remaining sum appears in the payment balances column. After all the relevant invoices have been flagged, we move to the parallel payment details sublevel form. Here, we can change the sum of any invoice that we want to pay only partially. When the payment is not intended to cover unbilled vendor invoices, we go directly to the sublevel form and record the sums and their details. When there is a gap between the invoice sum that was paid and the invoice's payment balance, we use the adjustment account column to cancel the remaining debt to the vendor for that invoice. By pressing F1 from the column, we can read a brief description regarding the automatic cancellation of small balances. To finalize the payment, we return to the upper level form and run the direct activation Finalize Bank Transfer Payment. The transfer now receives a permanent payment number, and the number of the journal entry posted in the ledger, in the general ledger, appears in the References tab in the Journal Entry Number column. To print a notification of transfer to the vendor for this payment, we can run the direct activation program Print Bank Transfer Vendor Copy. To print a batch of transfer notifications, we can run the same program from the Bank Transfers menu. Pressing F6 from the Bank Transfer Input column will open up the Payments by Bank Transfer form, where we can retrieve multiple transfer payments, for example, by payment date. And return to the program by pressing Escape. We can then use the Sort Input column to determine the order of printouts by payment number, or vendor name. After pressing OK, we are given the choice of printing, displaying, or sending the selected transfer documents. If you choose to send them via email, each vendor will receive a message confirming the transfer sent to the email address defined for that vendor in the system. To print a transfer notification to the bank, we can run the program Print Bank Transfers Bank Copy from the Direct Activations menu, or again directly from the Bank Transfers menu. Now we will demonstrate how to prepare bank transfer payments automatically. Automatic preparation of payments is based on the selection of invoices in the Flag Invoices for Payments form. Invoices can be selected manually or by running the Flag Invoices for Payments program. The Prepare Payments program can then be run to open pending transfer payments for the selected invoices. Finally, The Finalized Bank Transfer Payment Program posts the final transfers to the ledger. To select invoices manually, we're going to enter the Flag Invoices for Payments form. There, we'll retrieve the open invoices for a specific account and flag each one in the Prepare Payment column. As before, invoices that are flagged in the Checking column cannot be flagged for payment. The payment date recorded for each invoice appears automatically, though they can be revised. If we want to split a payment into several separate bank transfers, we can use the Partial Payment for Invoice sublevel form. There we record the dates, amounts, and details of the desired payments. The total sum of all the payments must be identical to the invoice's balance of payments, or the system will display an error message. To flag invoices automatically, we run the Flag Invoices for Payment program. In the input window, we select the vendor or vendors whose invoices we want to flag, as well as a range of payment dates within which to retrieve the invoices and/or the range of invoice dates, and click OK. A message appears displaying the results of the program. If we want to go back and repeat the process from the beginning, we can run the Delete Invoice Payment Flags program from the Prepare Payments menu, which removes the check marks from all invoices, whether they were flagged manually or automatically. The next stage in the process is to run the Prepare Payments program. In the input window, we can select the affiliate for which to prepare payments, if appropriate. Then we select the bank account from which to make the transfer in the bank account code column, followed by the desired payment date. If we are preparing payments with payment dates in the future, we need to flag the post-dated payments column and flag the one payment per project column to prepare separate payments for each project if the invoices are linked per project. In the next input window, we can choose whether to open payments by check or bank transfer, or by whatever method is defined for each vendor in the Financial Parameters for Vendors form. In that form, all vendors are assumed to be paid by check unless they are flagged by the Pay by Bank Transfer column. Select the desired currency and click OK. When the program is finished running, a message appears displaying the number of pending payments that were opened. If a message appears regarding errors encountered by the program, we can run the Prepare Payments Errors report in order to correct the errors. Now let's enter the Payment by Bank Transfer form and view the pending payments that were opened by the program. To do so, we will click F11 to move to query mode and select all temporary pending payments. To finalize the payments and post them to the ledger, we can run the Finalized Bank Transfer program either by the Direct Activation menu or by the Main menu. To view summary data on bank transfers, you can run reports in the Bank Transfers menu, as well as those in the Payment Reports menu. For more information, run the Bank Transfers wizard.